In this tutorial, you'll learn how the movie trailer that precedes every movie on this channel was created. You'll not be using the same assets though, but rather starting from scratch. This allows you to work on a simpler scene, which always makes learning easier. In this first movie, you start with the basic scene setup and then move on to work on the details subsequently. Start or reset 3ds Max. In the units setup, make sure the system units are set to inches, which is the default. Set the display units to meters, as it's easier to get a sense of scale that way. Ultimately, you'll be using Mentor Ray to render this project, so you may as well set Mentor Ray as a rendering engine from the start. This can be done in the render dialog, which can be accessed from the main toolbar or by pressing F10. In the Assign Renderer section, set Mentor Ray as the production renderer. If you are a regular on this channel, then you would know that I favor rendering in the 16:9 HDTV format. Set the rendering resolution to HDTV video, close the dialog when done. In order to frame the view better, enable Show Safe Frames in the perspective view. This way, you get a better sense of what's being rendered. You are now ready to create the needed components. You'll start with the water surface. It's easy enough to place in the scene. Use a simple plane object in the top view. Make it 2 meters by 2 meters in size, and use the Move tool to relocate it to the center of the world at 000. Name it Water Surface. If you need to, change its wire color. That's fine for now, although you will need to adjust its density later when you create the animated ripples. Next, you'll create the path for the animated arrow. Note that there are multiple animated arrows in the trailer, and that each apparent arrow is actually made of two arrows traveling together. Since you're only learning the concepts here, you'll focus on creating one arrow and one path. Using the Line tool, create a line in corner-to-corner mode, centered on the water surface, only a tad wider. You only require two clicks. To ensure the line is straight, hold Shift down after the first click. Center the line to the world at 000, and then rename it Arrow Path. Again, change the wire color if you need to. In the Modify panel, go to Segment mode. Select the single segment that makes the line. You need to subdivide it in order to create the bounces. Lower in the panel, set the divide value to 11, and then click the Divide button. This adds 11 new vertices to the line that are equidistant. Go into Vertex mode and select all vertices except verts 4, 6, 8, and 10. Move the selected vertices about 0.1 meters vertically. Keep an eye on the transform type-ins for reference. With the upper vertices still selected, right-click and set them to Bezier mode. Reset their tangents to ensure a nice flowing upper trajectory. The lower vertices are set to corner to provide a harder bounce as the arrow hits the water. Exit sub-object mode when done. Adjust the perspective view to get a better look at the contact points between the path and the water. This is where the ripples will eventually take place. Here, you'll be dealing with just one path, but keep in mind that the trailer has many. Also, the paths in the trailer are more irregular and zigzag a little bit. That can be achieved by moving vertices horizontally, not just vertically. Again, we'll keep it simple for now and leave the path pointing in one direction. With the path in place, you next work on the arrow object. This is what you do in the next movie.